section should explain the basic elements of the different stability matters and enable the user to know the different abbreviations, terms, and their meanings. Know and understand a transverse section of a ship. Know and understand a longitudinal section of a ship. Stability is the vessel's ability to return to an upright position after being heeled by an external force. For a ship to float, it must displace a mass of water equal to its own mass. Dead weight is a measurement of the ship's total carrying capacity. It is the total weight of cargo, fuel oils, provisions, crew, fresh water, stores, and so on. TPC, tons per centimetre immersion, is a measurement of how many tons that are required to change the ship's draft by 1 centimetre. The TPC may vary at different drafts and trim conditions. K is the abbreviation of the keel and is always at the same place. This is on the constructed line going through the centre of the ship, called the centre line. G is the centre of gravity, and its vertical placement is dependent on the placement of masses on board. Heavy cargo placed near the bottom of the ship gives a low G, while cargo placed higher in the ship gives a higher G. The gravitational forces work downwards as if they work in one point. The forces of buoyancy work all over the underwater hull. These forces of buoyancy work upwards as in one point, called the centre of buoyancy, B. M is the metre centre of the ship. When heeling, at small angles, the ship will pivot around this point. Its importance and placement will be explained in the next chapter. Perpendiculars are constructed vertical lines forward and aft, used for measurement purposes. The forward perpendicular goes through the forward end point of the constructed waterline. The aft perpendicular goes through the rudder shaft. In calculations, the length between the perpendiculars is often used and referred to as LPP. In the middle of the perpendiculars, we have the so-called mid-length of the ship. This is found by dividing the distance LPP in two. LCG is the centre of longitudinal gravity, and its placement is dependent on the longitudinal placement of masses on board. Normally, LCG is measured in metres from the aft perpendicular. LCB are forces of buoyancy working all over the hull, as described earlier. These forces work upwards as in one point. Normally, LCB is measured in metres from the aft perpendiculars. When changing trim, a ship will rotate about a transverse axis that passes through the centre of the actual waterline. This centre is called longitudinal centre of flotation, LCF. LCF is read out from the hydrostatic data of the ship at the given conditions. This is an example of a ship rotating about LCF. The block coefficient is a measurement of how much an underwater hull fills out a box with the same extreme dimensions.